Hello there. Let's see in this video how to apply professional slow, fast motion, and variable speed effects on your videos with Vegas Pro 14. Leave us comments below to help us improve our future video guides for Vegas Pro. The slow motion effect consists in reducing the playback speed of your video clip in order to highlight its content. To apply slow motion, just stretch the video clip from its edges while holding Control down in order to apply a time stretch. If you right-click on the clip frames and go to Properties, you can see that the playback rate has been reduced from 1, the original, to a lower rate. The maximum slow motion you can apply in this way is up to 400% slower speed. In order to make very good slow motion videos, you have to use source videos that have a very high frame rate. The frame rate is the number of video frames per second, or FPS, the video has while you playback. The higher this rate is, the better the slow motion will be. Let's see a clear example. Let's suppose to have a 60 frames per second video. Even if we reduce its playback speed by 400%, it remains quite smooth. But if we have the same video clip at 15 frames per second, we can see that the video is not smooth at all, but shows its single video frames following one by one. You may improve a little the slow motion by enabling the resample on the video frame properties, but its final effect won't be as much good as seen for the 60 FPS one. So, remember to take videos with a very high frame rate depending on the slow motion you want to apply. Whereas the audio part of the video clip is managed differently. When you time stretch the video clip, you will act on audio as well, slowing its playback speed. This is done without changing its pitch by default, but this may cause high distortion in case you apply a heavy slow motion. If this happens, just right-click on the audio part, go to Properties, and tick on Lock to Stretch. This will change the audio pitch, but sound will be much better and well adapted to your video anytime you stretch or shorten it. Let's now see all you need to know to make a great fast motion effect, which is the opposite effect that increases the playback speed. This is done by shortening the video clip, always using the time stretch. But in this case, you don't have to care of the video frame rate, since the fast motion effect also looks great if this is lower. Even more, the audio part will sound great whether you choose to keep the original pitch or not. What you really have to care for a good fast motion is to render at a very high frame rate. In fact, the fast motion increases the playback speed of the clip that needs a high frame rate to be effective. To render at high frame rate, choose your most favorite render settings, and as frame rate, type 60 to render in 60 frames per second. When you will upload your video in YouTube, you will be able to play it in 60 frames per second by choosing 1080p60 for the HD quality and 2160p60 for the 4K one. Check out our render settings tutorial to know how to render it in HD and 4K UHD. Eventually, you can improve your fast motion video by applying any motion blur effect on it in order to make it more realistic. To add motion blur, go to View and then to Video Bus Track. Then right-click on it, go to Insert Remove Envelope, and then to Motion Blur Amount. A pink envelope line appears, and you can pull this up or down to increase or decrease the effect. Check out the video preview. Inside Vegas, you can also playback in reverse both audio and video frames. Just right-click on these and go to reverse. Even more, you have the possibility to change the playback speed in time. The time stretch effect is very comfortable if you want to apply a slower or faster playback speed that remains constant in time. But if you want to make the playback speed change, you have to follow another way. If you right-click on the video frames and go to Insert or Remove Envelope, and then to Velocity, a green envelope line appears, showing how the playback speed of the clip changes in time. By default, this is set at the original speed, or 100%. But if you pull it up or down, you can increase or decrease the playback speed. If it is over 100%, you will apply a fast motion. If it is below 100%, a slow motion. If it is negative, you will play the clip in reverse. This envelope line actually allows you to apply any playback speed, even over the 400% limit as seen on the time stretch method. In case you apply a deep, fast motion, several gray markers appear at the top of the video clip, indicating the points where the video clip loops from its beginning. To change the playback speed in time, you can add points on the envelope line by double-clicking on it. Each point saves the playback speed value on a fixed point on the clip. You can click and drag each point and move them in time and velocity amount. This changes the shape of the envelope line and each of its fades. Also, right-click on each point in order to change the shape of the fade and to delete the point if you like. Also, the motion blur envelope line works like this by adding points and shaping the fades. Another nice feature inside Vegas Pro is the rate bar in the bottom left corner. This changes the playback speed of the whole project by moving and holding the gray marker or fixing the orange triangular one. But remember that this acts on the playback speed of the project preview. It does not change at all the playback speed of the project that will be rendered. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our complete guide for Vegas Pro for more amazing and professional tips.